foreign minister says the deposed president, Mohamed Morsi, is in a safe place and being treated in a very dignified manner. Authorities in Egypt are trying to calm things down, with Islamists vowing to fight the new government every step of the way. For more on this, let's go to Clifford May. He's the president of the Foundation for the Defense of Democracies. He joins us out of Washington. Clifford, let's talk about the arrest warrant for Mohamed Badi for inciting violence. Based on the events of Monday, do we even know, or are we closer to knowing what exactly happened on that day during those clashes when so many people were killed?
We don't know exactly. The basic details, as you've outlined them, are correct. There was a massive protest. The Egyptian military says they were under attack. They probably fired into the crowd. About 50, maybe more people were killed. There's fury over that. But it should also be said that the Muslim Brotherhood, whether or not it and its supporters were in that case unarmed or not, were attacking or not attacking, have not just threatened attacks, but have attacked. And I've actually seen video of Muslim Brotherhood people throwing their opponents off a roof. So I understand it's useful to claim victimhood, but there's going to be, and there has been, violence on both sides, no question about it.
But I guess the question would be, if you are provoking the violence but your own people are taking the toll, is this a tactic that is commonly used or would be used here?
Oh, absolutely. One of the things you want to do is fight the opposition through the media. And one way to fight the opposition through the media is to use your people, sacrifice your people, and then claim that you have been the victim. There was a Muslim Brotherhood spokesman in the Washington Post this week, and the whole op-ed was about how victimized the Muslim Brotherhood is, how peaceful they are, even as you have various Muslim Brotherhood spokesmen also saying, we're going to wage a war, we're not going to allow there to be any calm, we're going to bring down the Egyptian state if necessary. You have jihadist militias in places like Sinai, who appear to be attempting to attack the Suez Canal and boats in the Suez Canal. Look, it would be useful for the vast majority of Egyptians were we to have a period of calm now. Whoever you think is at fault, the military, the Muslim Brotherhood, Mohamed Morsi, put that aside, a period of calm would be a very good thing. I think it is very unlikely to happen. I think the military would like it, but I think and I'm not making the case for the military, but they obviously would like to see calm in the country right now, and they do have a plan that you might call Democracy 2.0, which would be a new rewriting of the Constitution, new elections going forward. I'm not sure the Muslim Brotherhood and their supporters are going to allow that to take place. If they can avoid it, I think you're likely to see more violence ahead. And whether that spirals out of control or eventually sort of peters out, that's very difficult to predict.
Well, then I guess if I asked you what could defuse the situation, we might not have an answer there.
No, there will be various voices calling for calm, but I'm not sure they'll be persuasive. There'll be other voices calling for vengeance, and they may be persuasive. And don't forget, it takes to have calm, you need a lot of people saying, okay, angry as I am, as much as I'd like to wreak vengeance on my enemies, I'm not going to do so because it's not good for everybody. But how many people does it take to say, I'm going to attack, or I'm going to be a suicide bomber, or I have hold of an RPG or an anti-tank missile, and I'm going to use it, and I'm going to show them what they should expect when they bring down my president.
All right. It's crucial, of course, for Egypt to show, especially Western allies, that they are back on the road to democracy and they want democratic elections again. As part of that, the transition team is moving very quickly. They've named a PM. They want to have elections within 7 months. The question is, are they going to be able to do what they need to do? Some of the people you thought would support them are not supporting them. So they're quickly losing some of the support that they have, and we know they don't have tremendous support already from the Muslim Brotherhood. So what can they do? Do you think they will be able to stand and move forward and stay in power long enough to hold those elections?
Very good question and very hard to answer. The military does have this roadmap, as they call it, for moving ahead. As you say, it does include elections and a committee to rewrite the Constitution. They have invited the Muslim Brotherhood to participate. For the moment, the Muslim Brotherhood is saying no. I think it's for the West, for America, for Canada, there's really no alternative but to support this effort. I mean, what else would you do? You do have the Saudis and the United Arab Emirates supporting the effort, and also, it appears, opponing up significant sums of money to help the government through the next period. There will be a sort of provisional government put into place. As you've indicated, it will be technocratic. In other words, people whose job is not to be political and is not to be ideological, but rather they are to say, how do we stabilize the economy? What do we need to do that? And how do we get calm? Now, this is an ambitious effort. It seems to me as good an effort as you could have. That doesn't mean it's going to be a successful effort. You've got some very angry people and people who don't understand necessarily in this part of the world, let me put it bluntly, the art of compromise, who don't necessarily buy the idea that it's better to have a half loaf than a choice between no loaf and a whole loaf. We've seen this in many other places in the Middle East. It's a very volatile situation. And that's why I say one can hope that there will be calm and that you'll get back on the road to restructuring the Egyptian democratic experiment in some way, shape, or form. But that is by no means guaranteed. It is not unthinkable to talk of a civil war in Egypt. And I don't think anybody was saying that a few months ago.
I just think it's interesting you called it the democratic experiment. All right, Clifford May joining us out of Washington. Thank you, sir, for your time.